I'm Colleen Parker. I'm an artist from Bountiful, Utah. And to describe myself as an artist, I think I'm what we would call a what-if artist, because I'm always experimenting with things. And I'll be doing something, I'll be working on a piece of art, and this idea will come into my head, and I'll say, oh, now what if I do this? And so I carry that through, and suddenly I've invented some new thing that I can include in my art. And then I'll do the same thing a couple of weeks later. I'll come up with, now what if I do this? And so I guess the what if would describe me better as an artist than anything else I can think of right now.
She can look at something that other people might ignore or not even notice, and from that little idea make something beautiful, as in the innards of a piano and making a piece of art out of it, seeing an oil slick and creating a design from what she sees, the soap making the design that dried on the top of her stove was an inspiration to her for a painting. Just amazing ways of creating beauty from next to nothing.
I'll do a series of something, and then I'll leave it and go to something else, and then I'll leave that and go to something else. And all of those things usually come about with, well, now what if I, you know, try a certain thing? This is a very small one, but you'll see some bigger ones. I call them doodles. But I started doing them in church, actually. If I could give advice to people who wanted to become artists, and I use this approach with my students, I could take a brush and say, do a brush stroke just like I'm doing, or I could take a pencil and say, do exactly what I'm doing. But I want to bring out their creativity. So this is what I would do with anyone who would want to be an artist. I would encourage them to experiment with things, and like I do, and just have fun. I don't even do my oil paintings the way other people do. I use oil paint sticks. I draw rather than using a paintbrush. And that's how I did this one, was using an oil paint stick. I build up the textures on that one. But you can make it as smooth as you want, or you can make it as rough as you want. You can build up textures. And I have done at least 4 big paintings with oil paint sticks. Art is my life. I don't know how I would have survived health problems and family problems and all those things if I didn't have my art. It's very therapeutic. Yeah, it's just, I started when I was a little tiny girl. I had a big sister who was an artist. I looked up to her, and when I would paint in coloring books, I didn't just put the color on, but I would make the blue shadows in the snow. All of those things just when I was a little girl. Well, I went to college on an art scholarship from high school. And I went to Brigham Young University on the scholarship. It paid tuition for the whole year. They were on the quarter system at that time. That scholarship was $100. And this one day, I threw my walking shoes down, and one of them landed upside down. And I thought, look at that pattern on the back of that bottom of that shoe. So that's the result. That's the bottom of my walking shoe. I did not draw all these figures as they came to me. in my head. They jumped out from the picture. Last time I counted, there were about 200 and something of them. And there are still some that are there that still want to be drawn. And it's so fun because they become, I get acquainted with all of them.
If I were to describe Colleen in one word, it would be amazing.
Innovative.
Positive.
Gracious.
Goddess.
Dedicated.
Resourceful.
Brilliant.
Elegant.
A mentor extraordinaire.
Enough said.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark.
Even with losing her hair, Colleen has been able to maintain her sense of humor. At our last gallery meeting, we all walked in, and there was this lady standing with this gigantic hairdo, and no one recognized her, and it was Colleen. It was so funny.
At all. All day long I can hear people talk.
Art is my life. I don't know how I would have survived, didn't have my art. It's very therapeutic.
But when you hold me near, you drown out the cry.
I was taken with her the first time I ever met her.
What's been said between your heart and mine?
To sum up Colleen, she is just not only amazing, but a very classic lady.
You say it best.